Okay, we are live.
Hey guys.
Wait, are we? Am I live? It says, yeah. There we go. It's live. Amazing. All right, guys. What is going on? This is Dani and
Robby.
Boom. All right. Yes, and Robby. What do we want to tell them right now?
We're gonna tell you the story and the strategy of how we set up this lecture and how we basically got over 90 people to sign up and over 300 people to bring their friends.
Exactly. And by the way, just to clarify, this isn't going to be boring. This is actually going to be super interesting. And if any one of you actually wants to promote something, you should definitely, just hear us out. Listen to this.
So we're going
to
talk about marketing strategies, how we got so many people to the lecture with just a couple of hours of work total. Just the strategy we did, how we planned it, and by the way, it's on Sunday, so feel free to come.
Yes, by the way, it's not too late. It's going to be packed, like that's for sure. Like, there's lots of people who we know are confirmed are coming, but it's still not too late, and we would love to see you there, that's for sure. Yeah. All right, so first of all, one thing is that we stand behind our shit. All right, now what does that mean? No, it's true. Now what does that mean? That means that we take massive action with a smile on our face, which that's exactly what this whole lecture is about. Lecture/seminar/workshop. It's conscious positivity with massive action. The whole point is to take massive... Robby, what the hell are you doing, man?
Waving at people.
All right. The whole point is to take massive action with a smile on your face, to actually enjoy what you're doing. And here's the funny part. The more you enjoy what you're doing, the more you will take massive action. One really feeds off the other. All right, it's really that simple. And I know that there's a lot of you that want to do that one thing in your life. You want to do this thing, whether it's the relationship, whether it's the diet, whether it's the business, whatever it is, and you say, someday, not today, someday, I'll do it in the future. And you imagine all these incredible, and you escape into your mind about this incredible vision of the future, someday. Someday is not a day of the week. And my trainer used to tell me this. He's like, someday's not a day of the week there, okay? Like, all right, exactly. He sounded really like a hillbilly, but whatever. And it's true. Someday is not a day of the week, all right? The time is now. The only time that ever exists ever is right now. Happiness only exists right now. It doesn't exist in the future. You might think it does, but when it actually happens, it's happening right now.
How did we go from the conception, the idea of doing this lecture, to in a few weeks with about one meeting that took like 30 minutes every week,
pretty much,
plus a couple of hours of marketing? How do we get to a point where we have over 90 people going and over 200 people interested? Very
with
simple.
With a lot of people who are confirmed coming, yes.
We basically do a lot of social leveraging. So we don't actually... go up to people like, hey, please come to my seminar, please come to lecture.
It sucks.
We don't really have to work that hard because there's a lot of ways to socially engineer a lecture. Now, the main two tools we've used, first tool we use to get lots of people to come is doing a really, really quick, easy video on Facebook. You can check it out on my wall, on his wall.
Secret Tel Aviv.
Yeah, we literally got to a point where people are contacting me and saying, hey, my friend showed me this video of you guys, and like, he doesn't even know you, but I was like, oh my God, it's Robby and Dani.
Exactly.
So the reason...
When your video gets back to you, you know you're doing something right.
So the reason this happened is because we know how to basically promote videos on groups. And there's actually a mechanism on Facebook that makes it really, really easy. To promote videos and get to 10,000 views, just like the video we did, even though you're not getting that much support. It's not very viral, not a lot of people are commenting. It's actually really easy to socially engineer the Facebook algorithm to start getting lots of views for your video without the support. And so you want to tell them how we did it?
Absolutely. Well, first of all,
just 20% of the people that came. The 80% of the people that came is from an even easier way, which we'll talk about in a moment.
Which, first of all, a few things, okay? Number one, a video with a lot of views is social proof, period. It doesn't necessarily matter how much people watched of the video. What matters is the actual view count.
The number,
right? Exactly, the actual number. People are like, holy shit, this video has 10,000 views. These people, like, who are these guys? It immediately creates some sort of interest. That's number one. Number two, what a lot of coaches or people who are trying to promote a seminar do, and I see them do this all the time, and it's a mistake, and I was guilty of this too, by the way, is you go to tons of groups.
Until I met Robby.
until I met Robby, exactly. That's thank you. Doesn't he look great in his suit, by the way? Seriously.
He looked great in his birthday suit.
There you go. They don't know that we're naked underneath this. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, if I had the body like you, I would go shirtless.
Little by little. Anyways, but look, here's the bottom line, okay, is that a lot of coaches, anyone trying to promote an event, usually post the same post in a bunch of groups. And you know this because if you're part of all these groups, you see notification, 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 notification. You just basically see a ton of people. You basically see a ton of posts all at the same time, and they spread themselves very thin.
Spam.
Exactly. Spam. They spread themselves very thin. They don't go deep.
Hi,
okay?
Nikita.
Hmm? Oh, what's going on, man? Yeah, exactly. The point is that they don't go deep. And we said to ourselves, Secret Tel Aviv is full of people from Tel Aviv. There's over 200,000 people there. If even 500 people, which how much of a percentage of that is from 200,000? It's nothing, right? If even 500 people from, you know, it'll come from that group, then holy shit, we'll have like a massive event. So we realized that it's better to focus on one group and just go deep and keep on bumping the post.
Yeah,
right?
So the way we leverage the Facebook system, you always want to play by the rules, but you don't want to be play fair. So what we did, there's a mechanism in Facebook where basically you have the Facebook group, and the way it orders the posts is based on who commented last. So The moment somebody comments, it goes up. Now you have big Facebook groups like Secret Tel Aviv with 100,000 plus people that are very active. And then you have some niche groups like 10,000 people that are less active. So there's less competition, but it's very, very focused. So what we chose to do is focus on one group. By the way, we could have focused on plenty of groups, but that would take a lot more social capital. And I'll explain why. So the way we leverage the Facebook algorithm is by basically getting people to comment all the time. So just leveraging friends, clients, family, anybody you can think of, and just saying, hey, comment on this post, comment on this post, ask me something, talk to me about it. And basically over a couple of weeks, we did the small competition. Like, oh, today I got two people to comment. I got one people. And the thing is, you can use a social capital, like contact people that you know and love you and ask them to comment.
But I just want to say one thing really small, though, is because like I personally had a problem. It's like I don't want to contact people. I don't want to bug them. Here's the bottom line. This is a limiting belief on so many levels. Yeah. Okay, and the truth is, if you don't believe in your shit and you don't believe it'll help people, I completely understand why. But the truth is, I really believe that what we teach needs to get out to the world.
Or even beyond that, like people, Dani was scared that people would be like, you know, stop bugging me, this is annoying. But actually, when you do that, when you take massive action and you kind of, you want to have a situation where everybody in your life, you use them to help you and they use you to help them in a mutual way.
Exactly.
So they help promote you, you help promote them, and you each do it in a very comfortable way.
And by the way, and why not? If and once again, if they're your friends, you want to help them out, they want to help you out. But even more than that, if you really believe in your shit, if you really believe in what you've created, then you shouldn't have a problem telling and broadcasting it to the entire planet.
Yeah.
And that's really what I believe we've created here.
Come to my seminar. So,
dude, nobody gets that.
So the idea is, every day just talk to just a bunch of people, like one, two, three, four people.
Yeah.
And just ask them, can you comment on our post? Maybe even tag them, and they just commented. And that thing alone got our video to over 10,000 views, and the other one to about 3,000.
Yeah,
maybe 2-3 hours of effort total.
Maybe.
Really, maybe. And the videos both took like 3 minutes to record, first take. Mm-hmm. So that's how one way we got really a lot of attention and
buzz.
Not just buzz, but also just the we looked very strong, because when you have 10,000 views on your video, it looks like a lot of people are interested. So that really, really helped us. And
what's going on? Dude, exactly. Dude, this guy was like the best participant in our last event.
Seriously. You should work for as a secret participant. In
Eli already is positive. That's the truth.
So, So the thing is, it looks good. It gets a lot of people interested. And the more views you have, the easier it is to get more views. The more comments that you have, the more easier to get more comments. Why does it bring Eli on camera?
Does Eli want to come on camera for a second? Okay,
maybe,
let's see if that works. Yeah, okay.
Maybe, let's add him.
Yeah. Is he on camera? Let's see. By the way, we have two lives going right now. We have Robby's camera and my camera.
The thing is, what we So what we did, because we created all this buzz, got 10,000 views.
Shit.
Highlight.
Guys!
Speeds.
Because Eli told
me.
Eli, do you want to say something really positive for a minute?
Very positive. Okay. Yeah, that life is an adventure. אני יכול לדבר בעברית?
לא, דבר על ההרצאה, אחי, נו. אנחנו בלייב. אנחנו צופים בכל שנייה, דבר.
זהו, אילה, אתה מדבר עם צופים,
מה זה? סתם לפני רגע. היי, נשמעות, ההרצאה הייתה מדהימה, אם זה מבחינת הדרך שבה הם העבירו את ההרצאה שזה. עליות אנרגיה מטורפות למצב של מורידים אותך לקרקע ומדברים איתכם. תכלס, זה כאילו הופך להיות ממקום של שמיים וארץ בקטע כזה, בקטע של החוויה, מבחינת התוכן, מלא ערך.
I just want to see, my live, you can't see it, but right now we have a guy giving a live testimonial. You can hear it, yeah, okay. כן, אילי, תמשיך אחינו.
כן, אז מהבחינה הזאת, ומבחינת התוכן, פשוט תוכן תכלס, דברים שאתם יכולים ליישם כבר, תחזרו הביתה, אתם כבר יכולים ליישם את זה, אני אישית, נגיד, משהו קטן שאני שמתי יום בוקר למחרת, שמאוד מאוד עזר לי, זה, אני יכול לספר, דני?
משהו קטן?
Yes,
which by the way, which by the way, something really small, he said that you're gonna learn a lot of tools, and he took one thing to apply. That's a great way to start, because sometimes in these seminars it can be overwhelming. Take the one thing that speaks most to you and start with that. That's what
so,
I have to say.
So we talked about the first technique of how we actually got a lot of people to get interested.
Yeah.
Now, the videos are not enough because there's two goals. You want to do direct marketing where you get very direct responses, like a Facebook ad, sales calls, things that require immediate response.
Yeah.
And you also want to do very massive, broad reach where even if somebody just saw your face, that's a success. So just massive numbers. So the video got together almost 14,000 views and counting. And we literally had people come up to us and say, hey, a friend showed me
your
video.
You're the guys.
Yeah, you're the guys from the video. And I was like, oh my God, that's my friend. And that's a sign of really, really, really strong marketing.
Yeah.
And that's what makes direct marketing very effective. Because if you just go direct marketing, hey, come to our lecture, but the person didn't see you yet, it would be very, very hard for them to make a decision immediately because they haven't thought of you enough yet to actually say, yeah, sure, I know this guy, I've thought about him sometimes, because there's a psychological trick. There's the way our brain works. The more you think about something, the more you think it's important. So even if I just every day I come up to you and I say, hey, dude, the stock market, did you hear about the stock market? The stock market, I just talk about it every day. Eventually, because your brain starts thinking about it a lot, you'll believe that it's actually important. It doesn't make any sense, but that's the way our brain works. So if somebody sees shirtless Dani, Robby,
exactly.
And then our seminar, he's like, well, I've thought about them a while, so it's probably important that I pay attention to this.
Yeah.
So that's the number one, the first way we got the 20% of the people, but again, it's 80-20, but
It's more than that. Once again, because the 80%, if they see the videos, they see that there's buzz around it. They see that we should pay attention. We don't know exactly what the percentages are, but yeah.
Yeah. So the videos got about 20% of the people attending, which is very nice. I mean, it's about 20-30 people just from the video.
Mm-hmm.
But again, it's not like it's two separate components: the direct marketing and the videos. They're both complementing each other. So just one without the other would not have the same effect.
Exactly.
So the second way we got people, and this is where the hacking really, really goes far. So first of all, you take care of the branding. You make a video, go really big, even 10,000 views. You got to that point, you're good. You look really popular. and you basically pin it on top of the event. So basically anybody that goes to the event page, the first thing or two they see is like, oh, it's got like a video of 1,000 views.
Yeah, exactly.
It's very, you know, people are thinking about it. And the way you hack Facebook to get lots of people to come into your event,
mm-hmm.
whether it be a webinar or a lecture, is you ask people to invite their friends into the lecture. So they go on the computer, only on
mm-hmm.
the computer, into the event.
Yeah.
They click on share, invite friends, and then they have a button that says select all.
Suggested friends.
Literally in one click, there's like 600 invites,
mm-hmm.
and your friends see... let's say your name is David. So David invited you to this lecture.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Just to be clear, guys, this is a notification on the side. It's not spamming. It's not like too intrusive.
It's,
exactly.
It's literally like a friend coming up to you and saying, hey, dude, I saw a really good movie. You should check it out.
Exactly.
And there's the social proof behind it, which makes it really, really, really effective. And also because it's massive, usually when somebody does that, based on how popular they are, you will get 3 to 15 additional people coming.
Yeah.
And the coolest part is that your friends are usually similar to you. So if you get somebody who's an entrepreneur to invite
mm-hmm.
all their friends, you're probably getting entrepreneurs into the event. So it's a gift from
there
Facebook,
you go.
A gift from the gods.
Or to be fair, there's also like little things, how one of the friends that I used for this, for example, or she agreed. So she's in all these groups that are like Tivuch, Dirot, Tel Aviv, and things like that. And it's people who are very relevant and they live in Tel Aviv. For example.
Yeah, so relevant,
so like,
location-wise,
exactly.
interest-wise, you can really go far with it.
Mm-hmm.
And now how do you do it? Like, because, you know, there's a limited amount of social capital you have. Like,
mm-hmm.
I have tons of clients, Dani has tons of people that love him, that, you know, girls' numbers, anything you want.
also,
but,
coaching
but,
clients and stuff like that.
And coaching clients.
Exactly, but yeah.
But again, like, okay, so you have like 5 people like that, 10 people, 20 people, 50 people, like how many people can you contact before you're like, okay, I the pool is dry. Like I can't just ask people again and again and again. So the way you reach new people is by giving them value, because there's this principle in psychology called reciprocity. And when you give somebody something for free, they
mm-hmm.
feel like giving you something back. That's why don't ever accept anything for free. In a sales situation, if you sit down with a salesperson, you're gonna buy a car, and he's like, hey, do you want coffee, dude? Say no. Like, literally, just say no, I'll just have water. Because if you feel grateful, like, oh, thank you for the coffee, like, he did it because subconsciously you'll feel like you owe him something now. So you'll feel not good about not purchasing from him. So what we do is reciprocity.
Yeah.
We literally contact people and give them tons of value. Like Dani helps them with women, with coaching, with positivity, some sort of action.
Here's the bottom line. Okay, no, I'm sorry, because Robby, you're selling me really badly. The bottom line is I make people happy. I make people happy, and I'm able to get them on a much higher vibration, and they're actually able to get shit done and enjoy life. That's basically what
so
I do. Dani
makes people vibrate. And I help
like
people
a human vibrator.
With business, with coaching, with focus.
Yeah.
And so we both have our values, and some of them are are the same. Some of them are not.
Mm-hmm.
But what we do is we help people, and then when you help somebody, they want to help you. So we basically just come up to people and say, like, after we help them and give them a lot of value, and we just go, here's all that free value. Now, there's one thing that you could do to help me, which is to invite people to this seminar.
True.
And we even send them a picture of how to do it. So it's like really zero effort.
Yeah.
And I guess about 80% of the people would say, 80% of the people say, like, sure, like, I did it. Like,
for example, like, I give coaching calls to a few guys who are struggling with women. I even give a coaching call to a girl who also struggling with men, for example. And in return, like, I got them to share the event with their friends. All right? It was reciprocity, like Robby says. However, with that said, I really do believe in giving without anything in return. Giving for the sake of giving. However, if that's all you do, and that's all I did for a while, you will burn out. You will completely burn out. If you just give, and you don't try and you don't get anything in return, you will literally burn out. Because think about it, you're giving all your time and your energy, but if you also have to work in, let's say, something else to also bring in income, it's just you're burning both ends of the rope, you will burn out. So
yeah.
I do believe in the principle of giving for the sake of giving, but you will reach a point where you will simply burn out.
So the thing is, when you give to people, you have to have a system of getting to. It doesn't mean that you have to, every person you have to give them, then immediately ask for something back. But you have to have these systems built in. Like, for example, we're promoting a lecture, so anybody that I give value, I can say, hey, dude, you know what really helped me out? If you share this, and it's not money, just share this. Or some people will pay. Some people will post a review about me. But always make sure to get the equivalent value back. And it doesn't have to be money-wise, but have a system. Have things you're trying to do and ask for people for support. And by them supporting you, you can do more to more people and do it better. And if you don't ask for support, you're basically going to run dry and you're done, you know?
Exactly. But just to clarify, once again, giving all by itself is an amazing thing. Without expecting anything in return is an amazing thing. Just very important to clarify that, because until we talk about conscious positivity, that is a very conscious, positive thing. However, once again, if you just do it too much and don't worry about yourself at all and bring in something for you, you will burn out.
Yeah, so, just to clarify.
Yeah, exactly.
Give, give, give.
Yeah.
But build a system so that you can focus on giving. And
you can give
you're
more,
get
more,
back.
More. You can actually give more. Once again, you can keep on giving.
Yeah,
more and
you know
more.
You get back proportionally.
Exactly.
So let's say, again, you have a really good sales process to take people from interested to giving them a free consultation to a small package to a big package. And it's all kind of built in. You're doing it automatically. You can just focus on giving because it will take care of itself. Or, again, let's say you have a system of getting people to support you by inviting more people to the lecture. You can just focus on giving value because you know that when you ask for value back, it's coming.
Mm-hmm.
So only focus on giving if you also know how to get back. It's really important.
Listen, it's okay. Yeah, exactly. All right, listen, let's move on from that for a little bit, okay? Robby, now that we're a few days out from the lecture, we've gotten a lot of people to show attending, show interest. We got a lot of people to confirm. What's the final phase that we're going to do to actually drive this baby home?
Yeah, so basically the way you want to go about this, and I've done the same process for a 500 people lecture that I did on my own in just 2 weeks. The way you get this done is you focus for the period on cultivating as much attention and people interested as possible, because the way social environments work and the way Facebook works, the more people you have that are coming, like right now, like I said, we have about 90 people coming and 220 people interested. And so now if you just post something about the lecture, we immediately get an extra 5 people. And at the beginning, getting 5 people is hard.
Yeah.
So the first 5 people isn't like the 50th times the 5 people after 50 times. So it gets easier. It's called the Matthew principle. It's actually from the Bible, and it's the sentence that says, like, those that have more shall have more, and those that don't have anything, even that will be taken from them.
Yeah.
And it's just success builds more success. So you want to focus on just cultivating massive attention and lots of people invited, and just getting really high numbers of people. And then Facebook makes it really, really easy to contact them later. So people that are already going or interested, Facebook gives you the tools to contact them directly and to basically make sure that they come. Even if you have a business page, anybody that likes your post, that comments, Facebook is like, you're not going to talk to anybody else, but people that engaged, you can just message them without even asking permission.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So you focus 90% of the efforts on cultivating, and then only at the end, only like right now, like 4 or 5 days before the lecture, we actually stop the marketing and just focus primarily on cultivating, on reaping the fruits, basically.
Yeah. And by the way, this is the final push, but the truth is, once again, this is providing value. I know that there's a lot of people who struggle to bring people to their events, and in general, a lot of people are curious about this type of stuff, and I really think, once again, that this live, if people actually decide to watch it, it can help them a lot with whatever it is that they're doing from a marketing standpoint.
Yeah, so if you like the kind of the average, the topics we talk about, and this is limited, at least in terms of what Dani offers, because Dani is more about action than talking. Like, it's not a lecture what he does, it's a workshop. He actually only does...
You will feel different immediately after
exercises, basically.
Yeah.
It's not like just talking.
Mm-hmm.
I do mostly talking, so it's really amazing, because in the lecture, we bring your energy to extremely high places where you're like, oh my God, I can't believe I got this excited this fast.
Exactly.
And then basically we take it down again by me going back to engaging you in a lecture.
Exactly.
And then we pull you up again and pull you down again.
And by the way, and these are the natural ups and downs that will happen to a lot of people in their day-to-day, assuming they're doing something that excites them. If you're just working in some office job that you hate, trying to get through the day with endless cups of coffee, then this isn't, the whole thing is, it's not really going to help you very much. That's
yeah,
the truth.
Yeah, because most of the lecturers are really disingenuous. Like, they just take you there and they pump your emotions up.
Mm-hmm.
And like, life is amazing. It's amazing. Everything is good. And then, you know, you go out there, you pay money, and you're like, oh my God, I love life. I love life. And then you like, hits you
and
in the mouth.
Exactly. So here we give you actual practical exercises and how-to steps.
Yeah.
For immediately after the seminar, because I hate that.
And
I hate going to something where it brings you up,
and
it leaves you with your dick in your hands.
On an experiential level, like, you actually pull you up, you actually go from zero to super excited, and then we pull you back down, and then you're like, oh my God, again? Pull you up, pull you back down. Oh my God, again? Pull you back up. But then you realize, basically, that you can generate that enthusiasm
all by yourself.
On literally on a minute-by-minute basis.
Yeah.
Or as Danny likes to say, on a second-by-second basis.
Make your cells dance. Your cells are having a party inside of your body.
Yeah, and the way our topics are very much intertwined is because I talk about massive action, and I don't really focus on positive emotions. I focus on taking massive action, getting results, and that's what makes me feel good, and that's how I like build my energy. Danny focuses on feeling extremely good, coming from that place and taking really efficient actions.
However, what I will say is that, like, once again, they do feed off of each other, because when I'm taking massive action, it also makes me more enthusiastic. But sometimes, let's say when you're not feeling it, you can use these exercises. However, what I will say is that overall, just the exercises alone will make you feel in general more happy, more enthusiastic, more excited on a second-by-second basis. Just that by themselves. And usually, when you're in that place, you can think much more clearly about the massive action that you actually want to take.
Yeah, so here's what you can get from the lecture. Here's what you're going to get from it. What you're going to get from it is a huge, robust, step-by-step system that will basically teach you how to go from an idea to accomplishing almost any goal that you have, how to think properly, how to strategize about it, how to go around and basically save a lot of energy, just get things done.
Mm-hmm.
And from Danny, you're going to learn how to feel amazing while you do it.
Well, because here's the bottom line, is that a lot of times we have these ideas, we have these things that we want to do, but for whatever reason, we can't generate the passion inside of us because we haven't worked that muscle. We haven't worked the excitement muscle. We haven't worked the passion muscle. And a lot of times when we're working from a place of scarcity, fear, doubt, you're just grasping at straws. You're trying to do a million things. Just make me happy. But what I can do, what these exercises can do, is that it'll make you feel passionate and excited and basically feel awesome immediately. And you can think from a much more clear-minded place, what's that thing that I want to do?
That's where
Robby comes in with a strategy.
I'm a very passionate guy naturally, but when I talk to clients and they're not very passionate naturally, and I try to get them to take massive action, it's really, really hard for them.
Yeah.
Because they're just not emotionally tuned to that level of activity.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where Danny's stuff really, really helps in taking massive action.
And like I said, in general, if you feel like shit and you want to feel better, it's that simple. This is basically a gym for your emotions. It's that simple.
Yeah, and any action which you take from a place of feeling really good is always better than an action taken from a bad place.
Of like filling a hole, filling a void, exactly.
Yeah, and the really fucked up thing is that, let's say, you know, you go after money or women or health, whatever it is, but you're coming from a really negative place of like running away from your bad emotions, you actually create a cycle of dependency.
Exactly.
Where it's never enough, I need more, and you never feel fulfilled. And,
100%.
You know, so many cases like that.
Exactly.
So you want to feel good now and take massive
action. Right. The whole point is that we just create permission slips in our mind. I need this, this, and this to feel good.
Yeah.
But a lot of times it's things outside of ourselves. And it's not our fault, by the way. This is how society basically trained you. You feel bad? Buy this mixer, blah, 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 which will make your life feel better. You know what I mean? Or with a baby, it's put a pacifier in their mouth, make them stop crying. In your case, let me eat something, let me watch a movie, let me maybe take drugs or alcohol. It's looking for solutions outside of yourself, and what we teach you is that you have everything inside of you built in already.
I have an idea for one thing we can finish with.
Yeah, sure.
How about you do the haka dance here, and I'll record you.
Oh, you motherfucker, I hate you.
Go
here. He's using social pressure.
Yeah.
He's using social pressure.
She
all right.
To say yes.
All right, all right. Which, by the way, guys.
Move here.
All right.
Ken.
By the way, guys, I just want to point this out, okay? Every single one of you, but actually, Robby, I want you to do it with me, though. Okay. Robby, you got to do it with me. You got to practice what you preach, man. You got to practice what
you
preach.
I don't preach that. I preach, man.
No, but it doesn't matter. You're with me in the seminar. You got to do it, man, okay? And I don't even know how well Robby knows how to do it, but the bottom line is, guys, every single person has an internal warrior. Every single person has that little thing inside of them that can just get shit done. Sometimes we need to wake that motherfucker up. All right, and a good way to do that is the haka dance. It's a Samoan dance, and it's used for war, getting ready for battle. I explain more about it in the seminar. We're just going to show you how this works, and then we're going to shut off the live because we've been talking our asses off. Okay? All right, we basically gave them a seminar right now. You know what I mean? We basically
exactly,
just...
Yeah,
exactly.
You don't even need
to... All right. So, Robby, just try to follow along as best you can, okay? So, all right, here's what we're going to do, okay? I'll tell you. It's four times. Da, 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 da. You know what? Just follow along. How about that? All right. This is the haka. Ah! Kamate! 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 Kiyoru! 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 Ah! 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 Now I feel like I can conquer the fucking world, okay? Now, Robby, what's up? Robby looks retarded, but it's okay.
Like this,
exactly, it's like a workout video.
Nice and back
then. Move, yeah. All right, guys, so I hope you enjoyed that, and let's get to work. I hope to see you guys this Sunday in the Pele, 8 p.m. Be there or be square. All right, Dani, out.
And Robby.
And Robby.